Previously, on Legacy of Ash.
The transfer's stuck at 50%.
Have you tried pressing next?
Yes. It's going again, thanks.
We got company.
There's another ship coming in.
Oh, your name is Mike? That's a nice code cylinder you got there.
Looks like the transfer's complete.
Oh, I got codes too.
What are you guys doing here?
We're here to rob the train.
Did we just become best friends?
The camera opens on top of the train speeding through the Corellian countryside. There are four individuals with mag boots sealed to the top of the train, and two ships kind of flying nearby, keeping close tabs on each other, trying to keep up with the train. Comms chattering over earpieces, and there's three kind of thugs on top, kind of closing in. There's a lineup, so the first one was up there, then the next one approaches, and then finally the last one arrives. And as you're kind of standing up there, you would both realize that you're here to rob the same train. And the one that's just arriving pulls his helmet off, and it's Chev. He goes, and then he kind of pulls out a gun, and he goes,
"Who are you?"
Funny.
And he
just dropped down and do a push-up
on a moving train.
And he goes, "Triz?"
That's right.
And you pull down your mask.
How are you doing?
I'm doing good. What are you doing here?
Same thing as you.
Yes, I know why I'm here, but why are you here?
We just owe some people some stuff.
The other guy pulls off his helmet. It's Grindr. No, no.
Oh my god, what is...
Okay, no, no. So, what was your answer? Sorry.
We owe some people some stuff.
Yes. Well, one of your crewmates owes me greatly.
Which one's that?
Who do you think it is? You showed up at the garage with that low down mutt.
Oh, that's yeah. Racist. Yeah. Shh. He's long gone. Long gone.
That's a deception check.
That is a deception check. Absolutely.
Alright.
Oh, boy.
And you have three purples for your difficulty.
Okay.
You got this. You've totally...
I'm trying.
Got this.
It's going to be a black because you are surprised to see Chev on top of a train.
It's been a busy 2 days.
It has.
It has. Still okay, right?
That's right.
Could that be a boost for me?
Because he's missing a finger. It still pains him. So.
It's only I think if I anything, that's going to be another setback because he's pissed off at your crew. No, just roll it.
Two fails and an advantage.
Okay. What would you like to use your advantage? Because you're clearly going to get caught lying.
I don't know. What would be good advantage?
How about he's only mad at Bruto?
Yeah.
He's fine with you.
Okay. He's mad at Fang.
Oh, yeah.
So you're like, oh, he's long gone. And he's...
Yeah, Fang died.
Yeah.
He's like, that's funny because we intercepted your ship's transmissions. And I'm pretty sure I heard that Mutt's voice over the comms.
Oh, that guy. Yeah. Yeah, no, he's still up there. I thought you meant Bango. Nobody likes Bango. He's long gone.
I very much like Bango.
We're best friends with him.
That's almost a second deception. That's almost a...
Now Grindr takes his helmet.
No,
the third one's Bango.
The third one is Bango?
Let's just blow the train up.
Oh my god. That would be quite the motley crew of characters. Holy shit. I
I'm going to say that the other two are Bango and Grinder. Yeah. It's happening. Oh my
God. They should just both move their helmets at the same time.
Is there a sticker on the front of their helmets that says Bango Krayt?
And you're like, yeah, we're best friends. And he goes, ha, this was it. Or no, Bango goes, fuck, that's his voice. You see one of the other guys, and he has his helmet kind of wrapped up all weird, and he takes off his helmet, and he goes, hey, ha, ha.
Ah, shit. Hey, just talking about you. Miss you.
Oh, of course you miss the Bangos.
Furs on the train, she misses you a lot. You never talk to her anymore. She brought that up the other day.
Yeah, that's kind of funny, because I left her a couple voicemails the other day, and she never called me back. So, same thing with Bruto. And Chip's like, who's Bruto? He's that Platoonian guy. You mean Fang?
Kill them both!
They know too much! Well,
you've got a chance! Hit your rifle to overload and throw it at them!
I don't want to lose it.
I'll buy you another!
And then Grinder takes his helmet off and he's like, look, are we doing this train heist or what?
You've got to be kidding me.
Hey, Toots, how's it going?
Who are you?
Wait, Toots?
I have no idea who that is.
Yeah, we had sex in the lawn chair outside your ship.
I'm still, like, burned.
Yeah, I still got nothing.
That was you guys that broke Roger's lawn chair?
Oh, that's Bango! Bango's guard was outside the ship waiting for you guys. There's a huge argument that ensues.
She just runs away.
Yeah, she just slowly creeps back with her megalock.
Deactivates them for a second, gets caught up, flies just back two cars, and reactivates.
Yeah. All right, well, you guys have a lot to talk about, so I'm going to go. Yeah, so so Bango's like, so what are you really doing here? Why are you robbing this train?
I told you, we owe people stuff.
Yeah, you owe me stuff.
No, someone else.
Yeah, who's the someone else?
Captain, what's happening?
Yeah, at this point, you guys are all looking. You've gone dark. And there's three other people, helmets off. No idea what's going on.
Do we need to shoot their ship?
No, not yet. We're good.
Not yet?
I got this.
Is that mean it's a possibility?
I don't know where this is headed, so you gotta give me a minute.
Remy, lock the turrets!
Okay, so, Bango says,
They can hear you. Their ship can hear your guys' transmission.
Yeah, so Bango...
Remy said that already!
Bango gets a... He looks down at his data pad and he goes, who are you working for?
Fiona.
Wait, that's who you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay, roll me a deception check.
That's halfway true.
That is halfway true.
We're kind of working for ourselves on this one, though.
Yep.
We came out on a...
So, this will be an easier check.
Okay.
So, yeah, we'll do one purple with one black.
All right.
Half-truths is best truths.
I got a success and an advantage.
Okay. So, Chev goes, Fiona, she is very powerful. Bango, yeah. Look, we'll deal with Fiona if we have to. What are you doing for Fiona? Why does she care about this train?
There is a piece of art that she really, 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 really wants.
Yeah, well, she's gonna have to buy it from us when we're done stealing it. Ha!
That's the only piece of art we need. You can have all of the rest. We just need that one piece.
All right, what's it look like? You have a picture of it on your data pad, so you show it. He's like,
I don't know.
All right, we can make that deal. You help us get in, that piece of art is yours.
Sounds good.
So how are you planning on getting in?
I was just thinking we'd cut a hole in the top and head drop in and, you know, take the piece of art we need.
Sounds good. Okay, so we cut to you guys welder cutting holes in the roof.
You don't know which con is yet.
They do.
Okay.
Yeah, they did research and they communicated.
They had more than 4 hours to plan a train heist.
Yeah. So,
think we're doing pretty good, all things considered.
Yeah, so they have to, they deactivate the external security alarms for cutting holes in the top of trains and all that stuff.
There's just everybody in their computer system.
They have quite a bit of some of this computer technology stuff like that. They cut the hole, and then they drop down, one by one, the four of you drop down into this kind of empty cargo room. So there was this train that has the passengers, that has the stormtroopers, all that stuff. There was this train that has kind of like just cargo.
We should get some blocks.
And then there's another one that's just pure sealed that you could not cut into and stuff like that. So the code cylinders not only work for that door, but also for this one.
Well...
So now you're inside the train without the code cylinder proper, I guess.
Did one of you say we had the code cylinder?
Yeah! I got one!
Oh, good job! You did something right!
Hey.
And Mike in the background goes, she did someone right, too! Yeah!
Hey. Who was that?
No, he wasn't.
He's not on our comms.
But no, he thought that just to you. Yeah. And you're like, oh.
That's right, he can't hear her thoughts. Oh. Yeah.
Yes. Also, like, how are you gonna get... Do you know what Vox means? Vox needs?
Shh. He goes, swamp.
The swamp.
Shh. I'm here with some people.
Shh. Who are you with?
Grinder?
Aw, did you guys have a good time?
What?
Bingo?
What?
I got three guys.
Remy just slowly flies away and breaks Atmo and jumps to hyperspace.
I'm not here.
Yeah.
Remy and I will go start our own crew.
I love you, Bria. Goodbye. Dun, 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 dun. Star Wars campaign. Yeah.
What's our plan to get Vox in there? Vox.
Hold on one second, okay? So I turn back to three. I'm like, you guys remember Vox, right?
Yeah, that little one that follows you around?
He loves art, and he just really wanted to see this collection. And so we were trying to sneak him in, and he's on the train right now with Var and...
That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
No,
your droid wants to see an art exhibit on a train?
Well,
gotta meet him.
Bango's like, hold on. No. Let me hear
some truth to this.
I saw Vox leave with two Twi'leks at the Blue Pearl the other night. Blew my fucking mind.
See? He is such an art enthusiastic person.
Question. Was that little droid that watched us have sex the other night?
Yeah. See, he loves art.
All three have met.
What a sordid reunion.
I swear to God, we better get off Krellia soon.
We know too many people. This is like an unfortunate stop at the grocery store.
It's like, oh, every single person I never wanted to see again. Perfect. Right. What is this, an ex-girlfriend reunion? It almost is for you.
Really? Yeah. I like this close.
Yeah. Oh, poor Bango.
Oh, no. Bango's tried the hardest, too.
He's gonna put out the loop.
Even the captain of the other silver ship
and
is
Bango's
probably
all mad about it because Grinder said that. So,
oh my gosh,
you had sex with him?
Wait, what?
He's gonna make Grinder pay for the lawn chair now.
Aren't you married?
Yes, a little.
Yeah, so we just gotta get Vox in here.
Also, Vox has the codes.
He also has the codes.
Oh,
with Var and Vox have the codes, so they need to get here, like, now.
Are you hearing this?
I don't know, are you still
are
on
you
the
broadcasting?
Comms?
Oh, no, you have to do this, otherwise it's not canon.
I'm not.
Otherwise it's not comms
not.
Canon. Yep.
Give me one second. Var, how far away are you?
Shh. This is, Anders. Remember to use code names!
Oh. Kara, how
no, he says, Triz, remember to use code names.
Get off the comm!
Kara!
Get black!
How far away are you, Kara?
I'm pretty close. Can you feel me?
Well, considering I have no idea what car you're in, I'm close.
I have no idea what car I'm in either. What car are we in, guys?
We're in the cargo pod.
The cargo pod.
You look above the door above Mike and it says cargo pod.
So I'm, oh, okay.
You're one away, yeah.
I'm one away.
Can you get back here, like now?
No. Really?
Listen, this is like super awkward for me. You gotta get back here right now.
I need help getting back there. There's a little bit in the way.
Maybe I can help.
You should do that.
Computers check. Right?
Yeah.
Let's I'm assuming you're not in gunnery anymore then?
No.
Okay.
With all this nonsense going back,
yeah, you're like, okay. These guys, we don't need to shoot at them.
Stop at engineering. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're like, we don't need to shoot at these guys. It's fine. Okay, so give me a computers check. You're already hacked in, so you'll give you a boost.
What am I looking at for difficulty?
So you're trying to create a false alarm, like in pod 2
like
or something?
Up in the front.
Okay. So that'll just be an average check.
How about 2 success, a triumph, and 2 advantage?
Okay, so you succeed.
All but Mike.
You have advantage and a triumph. All but Mike and Carl head up to the front.
Can I make it seem like a rebel attack is happening?
Sure, absolutely.
So that would
like
be
rebel,
enough to spur
rebel in sympathize or like mm-hmm. rebel terrorists are on like were found on the train. Okay, so to do that though, I'm going to need a fake communication from you, broadcast to the Imperials.
So it's going to be back and forth between Remy and I.
Oh God! Okay, go ahead.
So. Rebel Seeker, this is Rebel 5. Do you copy?
Copy, Rebel 5.
We have the train in sight. All good?
All clear. Preparing to extract information.
Charges are set. Ready on your go.
All right.
Yeah, we're going to make this thing blow up!
Boop, boop, boop. The Imperials start racing up to the front.
What is Mike thinking?
Mike is like, finally some alone time.
Your partner's still here.
And he's like, he looks loud. Over and he's like,
I'm Carl.
Yeah. So it's at this point it's Bria, Box, or sorry, Jean Grey, Box,
Kara.
And Mike and Carl. Okay. And then
Steve
other passengers.
Steve tried
other
to hang out.
Other passengers.
So,
yeah.
What was that?
Steve tried to hang out.
Yeah.
He's like, and hey, I'm gonna hang back here with you guys, okay?
No, Carl, you need to go. Sorry.
Yeah,
oh no, Carl says, Steve, you need to go. There's an emergency. There are rebel terrorists on this train.
Oh man, it seems a lot safer back here.
Look, Steve, when you get to be a sergeant like me and Mike, then maybe you can hang out in the back during emergencies and guard the precious cargo. But for now, there are rebels, and if you survive that attack, you might make sergeant one day.
Oh, okay. Yes, sir. I'll do my best.
So, yeah. Does Var think like...
Steve, why are you plugging your nose? Get out of here. Go.
Hand up the helmet.
Get out of here, Steve.
Does Var think that like, okay, this is our chance?
Yeah.
Oh, Mike knows everything she's thinking.
Yeah.
So you see your big window. She's telling you to come over.
So I'm thinking to Mike. Yes, Mike, sorry. Thinking to Mike that...
Is your name Mike?
Hey, you need to get rid of your friends so that we can go back there.
Yeah, and he's like...
But everyone else still doesn't know what's going on because we're still just talking.
Yeah, and meanwhile, they're just standing there and you're like, hold on 1 second, Bria. Or I guess Jean. Yeah. And Jean has, I don't know if Jean necessarily knew what happened. She's a proper lady, so she doesn't assume that. Yeah. So she has no idea what's going to happen. And then one of the stormtroopers turns and he says something. Are you close or are you farther away?
No, we're pretty close. I think we moved back there. We're pretty close.
So you walk over, and he turns over to Carl, and he goes, Carl, I know you're going to hate me like hell for this, but, I mean, come on. <It's done>. Carl slumps forward, unconscious, and Mike is like, well, that's going to be tough to explain.
He won't be here. It's okay.
But I might. I mean, unless you guys got a ship and, like, I can join it like crazy and just...
Yeah. There's a ship. You can join.
Okay, so you swipe the code cylinder, the door opens, and at this point, the three of them are in a full-blown argument over who is Triz's true love.
Hey, guys, do you need a code to get in that door?
Wait, don't shoot
at my new friend.
I'm listening to this.
Stormtroopers!
No, he's the one with the code!
Yeah, he's just like, oh, shit, what are you guys doing back here? What the heck? What the...
You didn't tell me the whole plan.
What the shit is going on back here?
It's fine.
Oh, I guess he might have known.
He knew something was going on back there. Yeah.
It's not 100%. Yeah.
No, but he knew something was going on.
Okay. And Box comes rolling up. He goes, frump, 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 frump.
What the hell is going on?
I got us the codes. Why are you here?
We're hired by someone to
but
rob
listen,
this art
who are
collection.
You hired by?
Arishen.
That might be an underworld.
Look, if you have to ask, Kay, you're clearly not underworld material.
Why are
that, that's okay.
Why are you working with him?
Listen. Listen. Kara.
Wait, what?
Just don't worry about it. All right, Kara, listen. We're
hey,
here.
Var.
We're
hey,
here to get.
Mike's like, what the hell, man? You know, he thinks to you. He's like, what, Bango?
And I'm like, no, never.
You say that loud.
Yeah.
Kara, listen. We're here to get that one piece of art for listen. For Fiona, whatever her name
Stop.
Is. And because Box really loves art. That's what
he's making. Aliases are hard. Yeah.
I'm doing French droid consistent. Over here. I don't hear it.
And Box really loves art, so he's going to look around at all the art. And they agreed to let us do that. And then they're going to steal the rest of it, okay? Whatever, we have the codes to get in the door.
No. Can we get a status report?
How's everything going down there?
Shitty. Shut up.
Did the alarm go off?
Shut up.
Yeah.
That's
all
not
ran
how this
away.
Works.
They all ran away. So now it's just me and Kara and Box and Jean. And then Kara picked up some rando.
Hey, I'm Mike. Yeah, Bruto. I haven't met you, but I feel like I know you.
You don't know my name.
No, I do. I've been inside Var.
And you get on my case?
That sounds really dirty. Anyway, hurry up.
We're on a timeline here, folks.
Hurry up and steal that art so we can sell
Remy,
it and repair
I'm
our shit.
I'm really not cut out for this type of work, Remy.
You're doing fine, babe. You're doing fine.
Hey, we're on a serious timeline here, folks. We are running out of track.
Quick! So, yeah, seriously, steal that art so we can repair our ship by selling it, and so we can get the money so we can repair our ship.
Remy's right.
We just need that one piece of art, though.
On the back wall, the door slides open, and Vox goes, "What, Fromp?" It opens into a pitch black room.
Vox, light up the room. I feel like you have the capability.
Yeah. So he just has like he just has
by light up the room I do not mean bring out any other.
No, he just turns he turns on his optical sensor to shine brighter yellow. Okay. So it's still really hard to kind of see what's going on. But he kind of goes in and then he immediately stops and he goes Fromp, which only translates to a droid saying fuck.
What is what you need here, Vox?
He kind of looks around and he plugs into a data port and he computes for a few seconds and then he turns on these kind of like light runners and it's a very dimly lit room and there's several like side cases and then in the far back is there's a collection. The five pieces are all at the back, all in this mega transparent steel display case.
Is that what you need, Vox?
Fromp.
Is that
that also?
You're good at taking things. Go get it.
The piece that Fiona wants?
You're the one who's...
I don't think he knows about that.
Oh, Captain, what piece are we here for?
This one.
Yeah, so it's too far away to see what the one on the back wall looks like.
Okay, yeah. Well, let's go back and look at that.
You're really good at taking things. Go get it.
Below the belt.
So you guys are all kind of standing in the doorway threshold, and Chev pulls out a can, and he just starts spraying this like smoky air out, and there's just laser beams cutting across the room like crazy.
What's happening?
Can you turn lasers off with your fancy computer?
I need something more detailed than that.
Lasers. There's a lot of them.
First of all, thank you for complimenting my fancy computer. Second.
So what are we talking about? A DJ or something? I need, like, is this a security system?
Yeah.
Is this, like, a child's play thing? Like, what are we looking at for lasers?
I have no idea. What are these, Kara?
Lasers.
Yeah, these are definitely, like, trip beams for this room.
Security
that activates something.
Security lasers. That's what they are. Can Fox do it? Can he get past them?
Fox, what'll happen if it goes off?
Wow.
You're in the system.
So I'm going to have you build him a computer jet.
One or two.
Like,
ranks.
Am I going to die if these go off, or is it just going to make our
situation worse? He has one rank in computers.
Okay. One success and one advantage.
Okay. We'll say that the lasers themselves cut.
Who's going to try to be super athletic? Do you have a rank?
I have two ranks in athletic.
And you're agile as hell, too, aren't you?
Yeah,
athletics uses brawn, though.
Yeah,
coordination is what you're looking for, probably.
I have no ranks in coordination, but I have four in agility, or I have two ranks in athletics.
This is not athletics, this is coordination.
Go ahead, get your piece.
Do you want to go, or should I go?
I think you should probably go.
All right, I'll go.
So... what exactly is going on? We're getting pretty close to
coordinate. I'm going for it. It's okay.
I'm pretty sure your captain's about to die.
I'm going for it.
Bria, what's your agility?
Probably a two.
It is a two. My agility is
Mike?
A two.
What about Mike?
He's a stormtrooper. He always misses.
He's an NPC now.
Yeah, he has a three. Zero coordination.
Should we send Mike in first?
The pussy wasn't that good, bro. Alright, I think the captain's going.
Yeah, captain's going.
To navigate a laser gauntlet of death.
Yeah,
laser
so
so do the lasers go all the way to the back? Is there like standing room? Like if this is your case with the art,
is there
like,
a landing before
room?
Death Central?
Yeah, so, like, I mean, it's just kind of lasers across throughout, so there will be, it's not just, like, really nasty, there's just a couple, because nobody, he's not thinking people with spray cans are going to be coming and stealing a 40-minute train ride, you know?
He's obviously never watched an action movie.
Can action I holiday. Flip a point?
Yes, you may.
You definitely okay. should.
So,
Kay.
I'm going to say that you get to set your own difficulty. And here's why. The lower the difficulty, the slower you go, increasing your chances of succeeding. However, the lower you go, the quicker the Imperials will realize that there are not rebels trying to blow up Kartu, and they will come back and find Carl stunned and Mike not at a station. And so it's really up to you. I will say that if you pick hard, then you will be able to get back there with a little bit of time to spare.
Okay. So if I take three, then...
Or what's... Yeah, what's hard?
That's hard.
I will actually say that inherently, one purple will be a red no matter what, though, because of the danger of these beams.
Okay. Then can I flip another dark...
Unfortunately, you can only use one per check, yeah.
Okay.
I will do this. You will get a boost. Chev gives you his kind of spray can.
Spray the can. Yeah.
Chev gives you his spray can, so all now right. It's kind of up to you.
Okay. He's going for hard.
One fail for advantage.
Yeah.
Okay. So, you fail to make it there in time. What would you like your advantage to be? So you will be progressed, right? You'll be somewhat into this mess.
By in time, do you mean we've reached the station or the Imperials?
Before the Imperials detect the ruse.
I would just think...
You'd have to, like, go stand back at his post and have Grindr or someone throw on.
Weekend at Bernie's with Carl.
Oh my gosh, yes.
So I guess Mike would be starting to panic, like, this is taking too long.
Yeah.
So he turns to you and he's like, what do you want me to do?
Go back out there. Stand your post.
I am way too high for this shit right now.
Just put your helmet back on and go stand at your post.
What are we going to do about Carl?
You're going to shove him in here. When they ask where he went, tell him that he got scared and went to piss.
Put him in a seat. Pretend he's just sitting.
Or have these gay hoos.
We cut to the door shutting with Carl passed out on a chair, blaster rifle in hand, and Mike standing there nervously like, this is going to be a bad day. This is already a bad
Mike,
day.
You're going to be fine.
It was a fine day, it was a good day, and then now it's a very much bad day.
Mike, you're going
to
be fine.
I don't fix this.
Welcome to the crew, Mike.
It was a good day, and now it's going to be a bad day. The story of the Kobolt Krayt.
You had a nice run.
That's the documentary title.
Oh my gosh.
Good days and bad days in the same days. Okay. So he might buy you guys a little bit more time. What's the advantage? So I'm going to say that's two advantage. Spent.
Okay.
I'll give you a boost on your next progression. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So go ahead and roll it. I'm going to add an additional setback to the pile. And you may use another additional destiny point.
All right.
Here. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So right.
Is it still hard to get all the way to the end?
Too light, five dark.
So.
Yeah, it's still the same difficulty. So the only thing you get is another chance to do it again with a setback.
Okay.
It's essentially the same.
Do I still have a boost?
Yeah, you still have the can.
Okay, and then another one for the advantage?
Oh, for your two advantage, yeah.
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 Okay. Maybe I'll actually...
Because you're getting close. The captain has to make the tough decision.
Right? Oh.
Those two cancel.
Okay, so those two cancel... That one.
That's a good captain.
Yay! I get four successes.
Okay. So you make it there pretty quickly after Mike goes and stands outside. So I'm going to say that one of your successes, we'll just kind of decrease the time, but your last success would be that you're able to get to a space and... You definitely have some movement room, stuff like that. So I'm going to need a knowledge lore or a super hard perception check or a fairly hard knowledge education check to identify the correct artifact the correct artwork that...
How big is
this
case?
Can she get it?
How big is this case?
Probably
it's got five pieces
across.
In it.
It's probably... 5 feet across or so.
How good is my mind reading right now? Can I do the presence check for it?
Yeah, like, you guys can still communicate, like, you're kind of in this together. There are ways to be smarter about identifying these pieces, but it takes time.
Does Vox,
so are you...
do you know anything about what you need?
Because you don't speak Vakis.
No, but can I, like, put my thing on him and press it so that he's talking to Bruto?
Well, who gave you a comlink?
Well,
what does she want?
Tell him what your piece looks like. What your thing.
What's the plan, guys? I'm back here.
He tells
you're at the case?
Yeah, I'm at the case, but I don't know what's
going on. A status update would be nice.
I just
Look,
got
let's
here.
Let's just take it all. We'll sort it out later.
Gene?
Ricky?
Can I get you to do a favor for me?
I'm kind of busy right now.
From now on, your one job is telling us what's going on in grueling detail.
Okay.
Like a surgeon, okay?
Continuous pay attention would be to nice. Detail
like
I had
a
to
surgeon.
Drop out of medical school, though.
Yeah.
We have faith in you.
Awesome.
Okay.
Vox, tell him what you need.
Vox is telling you what you need.
Captain, can you access the roof from there? The top of the car?
If I jump, yeah.
Are there any, like, lasers blocking it?
Nope.
Oh. Never mind. There's lasers.
What about the side of the car?
This car is specifically designed completely separate than the rest of the cars. You cannot cut into this without alarms going off.
Yeah, there's lasers everywhere. Barely made them past it the first time.
How long do you think it would take you to make the cut?
What cut?
In the wall.
In the wall?
If we don't know which one we're getting, we'll just take them all.
Well, I could try that, yeah.
There's definitely a lot of arc welding tools to, like, cut a hole in the wall between Chev and you guys and stuff like that. So there's enough tools to get the job done quickly.
But do I have all the tools with me?
Or I probably have yours.
You have one of them. Yeah, Chev has the other.
I've got one tool. Should I try?
Vox, what are we looking at? What do we need?
He communicates to you that he doesn't know which is the piece. He doesn't even know how the piece helps.
Alright, so I have my torch. Chev, can you toss me yours? Like, slide it across the floor or something. It'll make me go faster.
We're cutting a hole in the wall.
Yes.
You don't have to do that. You're talking right to me.
Oh, no, you're across. Okay, I guess we would because it's still pretty far distance. But he doesn't have a communicator, so he takes the one off Vox.
The Imperials will be on us in moments if we cut the hole in the wall. Are you willing to take that risk?
Yeah, totally.
Okay.
He slides it. I'm going to roll.
Guys, get ready for extraction.
I'm going to roll the force die and see what happens.
Where? I'm on the other side.
Okay, I rolled the dark side. So he takes his welding torch, slides it across, and it's sliding pretty good, pretty good, pretty good. Psh, splits in two.
Damn it, Chev, you had one job.
I'm not going over there.
That's a Chev I remember. Guys, we need to prep for extraction. We are running out of city, or running out of road.
Fine, you bastard!
How are we supposed to prep for anything? I'm on the other side of lasers. So is Vox. There's still the hole in the ceiling over there. So if you guys can get out and I can get out over here, then we're good, right? What piece do we need?
We don't even know what piece we need, and the Imperials are coming back. We have this is
taking
too long.
And now we're down a tool. I'll just take them all.
Okay. At this moment,
have we got the one for Fiona yet?
At this moment, Remy feels this kind of this moment overwhelm him. He sees in this darkness, he sees Vox, and he sees someone standing before Vox. Bent frame, reaching down and extracting a chip from within him. And she turns and she places this chip into this kind of art piece that is being sculpted. And she turns and almost, it's kind of this pitch darkness with this, like, the spotlight kind of moment. And as you're looking at her, she's in dark clothing. She has blonde hair. And she turns and she looks directly at you. And then you snap back.
Whoa.
And I guess you would explain the piece to be like a sort of a like a burnt red.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I just kind of describe the piece a little. Is there one that's kind of a reddish, a burnt red color?
Yeah, that's...
Yeah, and these are all like horrifying kind of masks that have like... They almost look like busts of just these horrifying masks.
So they're not like paintings, they're...
No, these are like more like sculptures, yeah.
Yeah, it's the middle one. Looking right at it.
Take that one.
What?
If we can only get one, get that one.
Why?
I have a feeling.
Oh, you have a feeling, do you?
Do we really have time to do this fighting right now?
Fine.
What's the one that we need for that scary chick?
It doesn't matter. We don't have time for that.
Was it one of these that are in the case?
Yeah.
You should totally grab that.
Okay.
You have two hands.
Okay. So.
So, I guess Bango calls out. He says, are we cutting a hole in this wall?
Yeah.
Okay, he pulls out a blaster and he shoots the control panels a couple times and it looks like the lasers deactivate. And he goes, we're damned if we do and we're damned if we don't. And he comes walking up and him and Chev and Grinder all have weapons aimed at you guys. And they walk up and they smash the case and Bango starts grabbing all of them.
Hey, we need one. Remember? That was the deal.
Hey, Fox.
The deal might have changed.
What's going on?
Fox.
What's going on?
I can't really talk right now. Your Twi'lek, this Twi'lek guy is double-crossing us. Hold on.
Can I flip a thing to have like a switch on someone's that they can just turn it on so we can hear what's going on?
Yes. Hey, Fox.
It's on constant communication
no,
now.
Oh.
Yeah.
I keep getting that mixed up. Fox, now would be the time for your special little toy on the top of your head to come out. aim it at one of the three over there. Aim it at Bango.
So Bango's collecting up these pieces, and he turns and he goes,
deal's changed. Aris paid us way too money to let a single piece get out of this collection.
Way too money? That's goofy communication.
He's Duro.
Fox, come to Bango.
Can I punch Bango?
You can try, but you're going to get shot by the other two, you assume, if you do. But sometimes the captain has to make tough choices.
Bruto's making his way to the gun turret.
Yeah, because at this point, like, internal train alarms and silent alarms are going off.
So I'm going to punch... Bango.
Okay. Alright, roll a brawl check.
With my mind powers. I'm gonna tell Mike to come back.
Mike!
Mike tells you immediately back, he's like, the Imperials just got back. Like, he goes, I'm trying to buy as much time as I can. You guys need to get out of there.
What's Mike?
Mike's a hero. He'll go on our
way. Brawl, yeah, melee is always one, isn't it?
Two.
Oh, yeah.
Two?
Melee and Brawler are always two, yeah.
Okay.
Hey, I'll even give you a boost. You wanted to bang... You wanted to punch Bango in his in face since you met him.
Pretty much.
Get him right in the face. Right in the kisser.
I got two successes and an advantage.
Okay. So you punch him really hard in his face. You deal him a good swath of damage. And it kind of knocks him back. He ends up dropping this red art piece. This sculpture falls to the ground and shatters. And he kind of, and then Vox fires his disruptor pistol and hits Bango right in his arm. And he drops two more pieces and they shatter as well. And we're going to roll initiative. So Vox shoots Bango, strikes him right in his arm, and his arm just bursts into this kind of ash and just rips itself from matter. And it's just this burnt stub.
and
the screen.
These two.
I think it's warranted.
So Bango screams, drops two more of the pieces, they shatter. This is countless credits worth of priceless artifacts, and three of them have now shattered to the ground. Vox is, his eye turns red. He's furious.
Can he just be red with a crosshair?
Yeah,
that's his targeting.
It's, yeah, it just looks like a targeting scope, and he just starts wheeling forward into the mayhem kind of thing. So the three have weapons pointed at you guys, at you specifically. We'll probably go with you first because you're actually in the room versus these two who are not.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, so you guys just hear like blasters and screaming, and you're not entirely sure what's going on.
Fortunately, we hear everything now.
Yeah, but you're kind of confused because you don't know if the stormtroopers might have burst in too, is the thing. Because you're just knowing that Bango's pulling some shit, but you're not knowing quite what's going on.
Right.
Yeah. Okay, so it's your turn.
So I guess I would try to shoot at one of them.
Okay. Yeah, that's yeah, so you have a clear shot at Chef's back.
Okay, that's where I'm going.
Please kill him.
Well, this didn't work out nicely. That's a complete wash, right? Mm-hmm. No, it's not. I have
one advantage,
lack of success.
Okay, so you shoot and you miss. What do you want your advantage to be? What beneficial thing happens from you shooting into this group?
They don't know it was you. Sure.
I mean, a small blaster bolt compared to a disruptor pistol.
Yeah.
Okay, so they're both going to shoot you for punching Bango, and they're not entirely sure what's happening, but Bango just started screaming right after you punched him, and his arm melted away, so...
Holy shit!
They're a little confused at what's going on, so...
She can punch off arms!
Yeah, they're both gonna shoot at you. Yeah, so this is gonna be probably pretty scary.
I should have run and stabbed them. She already has a crit. This is your fault. I'm sorry.
Actually, we're going to say that Chev has a weapon out, because I did say previously that only one of them had a gun, so they both brandish vibro axes. Okay, one hit, one success, one advantage. So he deals you 7 melee damage. It has pierce 2, so it ignores 2 of your soak. Then the other one's going to also swing at you. Same exact dice pull, off flip another one just to give you guys some points back. One success and one threat. So, yeah. So you're gonna hit by for the same another 5 damage.
Can't believe Grindr would do that.
Right.
You guys had a special thing.
It's you okay, did, but he's,
it wasn't pretty.
He's in a swoop gang and he knows a job is a job. So
it wasn't pretty, but it was special.
It wasn't pretty.
I shouldn't have kicked him out that morning. Jeez.
Yeah, you wouldn't even let him have tap water, so don't you play like... You wouldn't even let him drink any tap water. Okay, right, so you guys definitely hear commotion going on. You're not entirely sure what it means, though. But it is your guys' turn. Okay. Actually, yeah, because Bango is not going to do anything. He's just, like, screaming and trying desperately, like, to try and hold these two. There's only two left. Three of them smashed.
I thought only two of them smashed.
Three have smashed, yeah. So he only has... He has one arm and he's desperately trying to hold on to these. Not entirely sure how to...
Jean, what's happened?
She forgot her name is Jean. You guys are talking to her. No response besides more, you know, fighting and tumbling and blasting.
Remy, bring us up behind the train. If we have to, we'll shoot the back off and they can come out that way.
Roger.
Okay.
Yep. Stay on target with the train.
Yeah, I guess stay on target.
Okay, you guys. So let me get a. Either one you can do this, but go ahead and do a computers check.
I think I
that's you.
And this will be calculating the time left over before Cornet.
Difficulty.
A lot has happened, easy. So I feel like 3 seconds.
Wow.
Wow.
Lack of success with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 advantage.
Okay, 5 advantage. You keep trying to do it, but you keep hearing screams and you keep stopping to get status updates. So what do you want your... I'll give you 4 of your advantage would be that you understand that these three have double-crossed your team, and it sounds like
they're tearing those guys apart.
Okay. Is their ship still hanging out?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Like, was right next to ours. Shoot it.
If you want to, you don't know anything about this ship or its complement.
Oh, that's true. We have other priorities.
Your ship has more damage than theirs, I guarantee that, because their ship looked pristine. And your ship has carbon scoring from a decimator.
Yeah, we'll just reel it in.
I was going to say, if you get a good volley off right off the bat, like, you might do something, but that's a risk that's really dangerous to take right now.
We need to get out.
Okay.
Yeah. That's priority one.
All right. So, you guys are just kind of keeping pace behind the train. Now, there are cars behind. This is in the middle of the train. It's not the rear of the train, so this is going to complicate this.
So, basically, going to be setting off sensors and stuff, but I am
kind of
pretty
flying.
Much the car, like, right above the car
behind
that one.
Okay.
So I'm sure I'm setting off sensors.
Okay. How's this? Your girlfriend and your party and your crew are getting torn up pretty bad, right? What if you are, like, flying the ship sideways, guns aimed at the side of the train?
Can we just shoot a hole
in
the side?
Just, like, ready to just blow a hole in the side to get the ship out of there, you know?
Can we do that, too?
Okay. So go ahead and roll me that gunnery check. Actually, to do the computer's check, you wouldn't be in the gunnery field. So that'll be next turn, okay? So we're going to cut back to into the room. You just got double axed to the back, right?
Double axed to the back.
Exactly.
Can I shoot at him? I'm, like, the closest.
Yeah, it's going to be very hard to shoot at him because you're point blank.
And
so
you have Grinder in your face.
Grinder and Chev.
Mm. Can Vox shoot Grinder or Chev?
So do you guys want Vox to go first?
I have no idea. No, I want Vox to find whatever it is he needs to find. I guess I'm going to shoot at them with my blaster rifle.
At who? Because they are rivals.
At Chev first.
Okay.
aim to try and shoot off one of his remaining fingers. He's just got a thumb.
Okay, so go ahead and aim. You are engaged with him, so the difficulty is going to be 3 purples.
I have 3 fails and 1 advantage.
Okay, so you shoot, you miss, you almost hit Vox. Mm-hmm. What's your advantage?
It does kind of make Chev step back a little bit.
Sure.
I'm going to run and take the 2 masks from Bango.
Before he loses another arm.
Yeah.
Check is that?
Athletics.
Okay, athletics is out of brawn. I have a brawn of 1.
Well, he has 1 arm, so...
And is going into shock.
Yeah, so you're actually... It's not as bad as you might think. So I will say the difficulty is 1 purple. You do have a boost because
he has 1 arm and he's still screaming.
You might want to flip a destiny for this one because it would probably not want to drop any more.
Or we'll say he has been disarmed.
Hey.
Well, from what I can see, you've already succeeded.
Yeah. 3 successes. So you succeed with 1 threat. So you grab both of them from him. So as you're...
You feel bad because you just stole these things from a one-armed guy.
Well, I'm like... we'll make you take 1 threat because, like, truthfully, you guys have really just shit on Bango.
Yeah.
Yeah, and, like, it's kind of crappy, you know? Like, this
so
poor guy.
So 1 strain.
Yeah, so just take 1 strain. Okay, Bango's still just screaming. His arm was atomized. So, he's gonna frantically, dangerously, like, turn and try to grab these things back from you again. So he's gonna do the kind of same thing. So he's just gonna struggle with you. Okay, so he grabs for him, You kind of ripped the last one out, and he kind of scrambles for you, right? Kind of scrambles, and he falls down to his knee, and he's just kind of, like, clutching at your ankle as you, like, stepping away from him, looking down on him in pity, and he's just screaming in, like, pain and just defeatedness.
At least he can go into a new field of business, though.
Yeah.
Bango's biotics.
So the. So Grinder is actually going to turn, and he's going to hit you with an axe instead.
I'm a lady.
Well, I guess he doesn't really want to hit the captain anymore because...
He feels kind of bad about it.
He feels bad about it. So I have one threat and one success. So the success will deal 7 damage and piercing 2. You have a soak of 2, so you take all 7 damage.
Okay.
So he hits you pretty seriously right in the back with an axe.
Okay. So I have one wound from the last time I ever played, and
so
that never
healed, still,
right?
Yep.
Okay,
so you are now at 8 of your 11 threshold, so one more axe like that, and you're done. Shev is going to hit you with his axe as well. One success, 2 advantage, and a triumph. He's going to hit you, he's going to crit you, and he's going to drop you prone.
I am down to 0...
She's at her threshold. She's
okay, so you're still good. Because in Star Wars, you count from 0 up to your threshold, and when you surpass your threshold, then you fall unconscious.
Okay.
So you're at your threshold. You will be crit, though. This is going to be a pretty nasty crit, because this is a vicious weapon.
Yeah.
So I'm adding 40 to my percent dice. Your previous crit, and it has a vicious 3. So this is adding 40 to it. Okay, I got 90, which means you are compromised. So I rolled a 50 on the dice, plus 40 is compromised. It's an average crit. Increase the difficulty of all checks by 1 until the end of the encounter. So no matter what, 1 purple will go to a red for free because you are compromised. Okay, so it's looking pretty grim for you. You're feeling like the darkness kind of creep around your horizon, like around the edges and stuff.
We're gonna go back.
It's your guys' turn.
Shouldn't Vox have found someone?
Yeah, so Vox actually blew right past. You grabbed these art pieces as Vox like kind of goes between you. Mm-hmm. Bango trips over Vox, and Vox walks over, or rolls over, and he's immediately frantically searching the shattered pieces of these sculptures.
Okay. Can I see Jeff?
Through this doesn't have windows. We had previously established. Yeah.
Well, then I think I'll open a door.
Okay.
On the side of the train.
Yeah, fair enough.
You gonna give us all a warning of where you're gonna shoot?
There's no time. Roll it.
It's my difficulty.
To shoot a train in the broadside.
We're traveling the same speed
1.
As. Can I hit the train? I think if I miss, I might still hit the broadside of a train. I have 1 success.
You hit the broadside of a train.
Hooray!
And how much weapons? How much damage does a weapon?
7? There's a 6.
Seven.
Probably enough to punch a hole in the side of a train.
Yeah. 6 damage.
Okay, so I'm going to... we'll say that this car in particular has a higher armor kind of ratio. So you punch a smaller hole, 1 more shot... would probably rip a bigger hole in the side. So you have a window, 1 more to make a door.
Who's in front of that window?
I think the Destiny pool might decide that. Okay, it is Remy's turn.
Okay. Unfortunately, there's not a lot I can do ship-wise.
Okay, so the other ship is coming back, and now that you're shooting into the train, like, they know stuff is going bad. So you see them getting close and, like, they're lining up to extract their team instead. Mm. And then they kind of ram into you and you're starting to do, like, this kind of vying for position.
They're just a little ship, right?
So roll me a piloting check and the this will determine who basically is getting the upper hand.
So, like, a contested
kind of
piloting, basically?
Exactly.
Basically
exactly.
A game the advantage?
Yeah.
What is the difficulty of their pilot, then?
So we'll say 3 and 1. So you have... 2 purples and a red.
Okay. I 1 success and 1 threat.
Okay. So you 1 success and 1 threat. Okay. So you bound you give them a little sway. They overextend. You slam into them. They kind of drop down and they're definitely off course. They're not in any good place to line up a shot.
Uh-huh.
And so you're lined up perfectly for his shot next turn.
Okay.
Okay. We're gonna cut back inside. You're prone.
things are looking grim. You're
crying alligator tears.
Rip these things from Bango's one hand, one arm.
And got hit in the back of an axe.
Yeah, that's also something that happened too.
Am I going first?
Actually, we could have you guys go first if you wanted, and then you could cut them.
Yes,
last,
please.
Because I think that would be most fortuitous, yeah.
Whom can I see through this window?
We'll say that you see Grindr.
Could it be Chav?
for a destiny point, yes.
Well, I don't know. Grindr might be kind of satisfying, too.
Go for Grindr.
I would say Chav is...
More...
Chav is thematically better.
We'll pull for Chav.
Yeah. Okay. So Chav is in the... Chav is a tiny little window. What you could do is you could increase the difficulty and hit him with a starship scale weapon.
How high?
I'll just make it three purples.
Can I get a boost because it's Chav and I don't like him?
Sure.
I will aim. And I want to use a force point upgrade.
Yeah.
Great.
Somebody's about to turn into purple mist. Hopefully.
Hopefully. Don't jinx that.
I'll allow it.
So I have one fail and four advantage.
Okay, so what do you want your advantage to be?
So I'd like my advantage because it's going to hit.
Okay, how about this? I have an idea. With your permission, you basically slam some laser bolts up against the train side. Chav realizes that these are getting like really close, and so he dives out of the way. So he's far away. He's not threatening to your party members.
I will take it.
Okay, cool. The ship is coming back. They're going to hit you one more time.
So that same...
Yep.
Thing.
And...
there's now a door in the train, right?
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
Okay. You could probably get through.
With his miss, it hit the train more than the person, so yes, there's a bigger cut in the wall.
And I'm yelling at Anders to open the side door.
Oh, it's already open. Yeah, he has the cable down. He's feeling pretty heroic, yeah. He's definitely ready
this
to
this is
help.
Where you make your pay!
Do I get a vote if this goes well?
We'll talk about it!
I'll tell you what, Anders, if there's still a crew left, maybe we'll let you vote. Alright.
Alrighty.
Oh, so, okay. So, here's what we're gonna do.
Okay.
I've actually learned about this kind of fun house rule recently. Okay? And because you guys are in dire straits, I'm going to activate it. The house rule is this: if you ever get to all dark side or all light side, you can flip them all. Okay?
Okay.
But something terrible happens. Okay? And I'm going to do it.
Do you have permission to do it?
You guys determine if it's all light to dark, and I determine if it's all dark to light.
Bye bye, Anders.
So, how does that affect my dice pool?
It doesn't.
At all?
It doesn't. So, I'm gonna let you have that, so you can have these destiny points. I'm gonna brainstorm over here and figure out what exactly terrible is happening right now.
So he can flip one though.
You absolutely can flip one if you want.
Well, then I'm going to.
You might as well.
So I do succeed. Two success with three advantage.
Okay. Two success, three advantage. So yeah, you hit their ship pretty hard, and they're one of their kind of engines, because your ship has a little bit longer of a back, a little bit sharper edges on the back, mm-hmm. so it rams, you kind of fishtail a little bit, hit their engine explodes and starts smoking really bad. That's going to cash in all your advantage and successes, but they're not going to be able to stick around very long or at all, because their engine just blew up and is smoking really bad. Cool. Inside the train, the bad guys are going. Chav hears a loud explosion. There's laser bolts barreling into the ship. He is going to basically spend his turn calming the ship, telling them that, like, It's over, like, they need extraction right now, and there's just frantic chatter back and forth, so that's not happening. So Bango is going to frantically scramble at you again. This is going to be not very good at all. He's going to have three setbacks.
He's shock setting in.
Well, he's prone, trying to out-grapple someone. Yeah, three of the five dice went blank. So he has a failure and a threat. So he, he just kind of rolls over onto his back, and he just kind of gives up.
How close is Bango to this giant hole in the side of the tree?
Are you just going
to
roll him out?
So the hole would be a little bit higher of an angle, so it would be something you have to climb out of. Yeah, I was going to say, you're more than welcome to try, but with the Brana 1, you probably won't be able to hoist him out. Yeah.
No.
The captain might be able to.
Captain's got her own problems right now.
Throwing people off of things?
Yeah. Okay, so he scrambles at you. I do have Grinder.
Grinder's engaged with her.
Yeah, so we're going to say that Vox reaches down, takes his cloud, and picks up a computer chip.
Do I see this happen?
Maybe. One second. So he pulls it in, and he turns and he goes, Womp! And he's like, yeah, so he's super excited, and Grinder's going to bury his axe into Vox.
I'd like to upgrade the difficulty.
I'd like to flip them all and upgrade all the difficulty.
How do you guys care about Vox?
Only a little.
Yeah, we don't care about each other, but as soon as Vox is in danger... Can he get a setback? Because he doesn't know what the... Because...
He's going to hit Vox pretty hard. Yep, so he hits Vox for 3 successes. That's going to deal 9, pierce 2.
Even droids have soak.
Okay, so he buries this axe into Vox's head, and Vox just goes, whoa! Like, sparks start shooting out where the axe was buried, and Grinder rips the axe back out.
I hope he didn't hit the disruptor.
It's a lot of damage. One more like that, and Vox is out of commission. Okay.
Can I shoot Grinder?
You may.
Can I also shoot Grinder?
You may.
Everybody shoots Grinder. I want a shot on Grinder.
Can I just come over the comms and cry?
That's a free action.
That's what I'm doing. I just come over the comms and you guys just hear me cry. They're not even paying attention.
Speed.
Maybe.
I have to stand up first, right?
Yep, so that will cost you a maneuver.
Yeah. But I can still shoot.
Absolutely. Well, now you can suffer 2 strain to aim if you wish.
Yeah.
Okay.
Smoke him. You want to upgrade too?
We got the butch!
Yeah. He's trying to murder Vox.
While she's doing that, I just cry across the comms. Bruto, can you fix Vox?
There's good news and bad news.
So
no, it's just bad
Bria
news.
Bria calls out and she goes, Remy, things are getting really bad out here. We need to get out of here now. And then you hear, Mike tells you that you guys have a few seconds to get out of there.
Guys, we gotta leave now. And someone has to carry Captain and Vox.
What happened? So you shot at Grinder.
Yeah.
Failed epically.
I got 1 success, 5 advantage, and a despair.
Okay. A despair means you shoot an ally.
No.
Yep. You're gonna shoot Vox.
Can I jump in front of Vox?
If you want.
When he got shot, when he got hit with an axe, I jumped in front of him. She shoots me.
Okay. You shoot Var instead.
My damage is 9, though. And you have,
like... She won't die. She'll just fall down.
Yeah. Just don't use your advantage.
I will go over my threshold.
Just don't use your advantage to crit, though. That's the thing. Just don't crit. Yeah.
Fine, I won't.
So what does happen, though? Because I only... I'm
so
at
8,
and my threshold is at 11.
Okay, so she hits you for 10 damage minus your soak of 2.
So is that even
damage.
Allowed, though? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So you go up to 16 wounds.
Okay!
So you will drop a tick of crit.
Yeah. Yeah, because when you're unconscious, I'm going to make you guys roll your own fate. That way... Okay, that's a pretty wimpy one. While unconscious, you're also distracted. You may not perform a free maneuver during
little
your next turn. Yeah.
So just
write easy crit, yeah. Oh my gosh, this is crazy. Okay, so here's what happens.
My droid friend.
You shoot, she dives to protect Vox from Grinder. She gets shot in the back. From the other side of the door, you hear a frag grenade go off. Boom! And then silence for a moment. I need you to roll this. This will determine artifacts and there are these this artwork.
Shit!
Because you're holding on to it and you fall prone. Okay, so one of them breaks, one of them doesn't.
We got one left.
One remaining.
Fox found his chip, though. Let's hope it's the one Fiona wants that didn't break.
I'm going to board the ship.
Okay.
As probably the only person capable of boarding the train.
Okay. So we cut to Bruto at the sticks and...
trying to only use
Remy
one hand.
Remy and Anders on top of the ship. And they're going to run and jump onto the train. You guys run and jump onto the train, and then within moments, you slither down into the open hallway.
Okay.
Okay. And you draw your blaster and say,
"Wow, I'm just like Spawn Wayne in that one movie, 310 to Yavin."
And the joke comes back full circle, and now it's funny. Okay. We'll let them decide. We'll let them decide. Yeah. And, yeah. And Anders goes, "Art show's over." Yeah, he's a Sparnold Spacinator. Yeah, you guys are doing shitty action movie references now.
Anders, you're losing a pay cut for that one.
He rips the headset out and just starts firing into the crowd. Okay.
Most of these are our people, Anders.
This is where he turns. No, cool. So, that was your guys' turns. You're up.
Kill Grinder.
Or Var. I mean, you're one for one right now.
Right.
Okay, what's gonna happen?
I'll try talking to him, I guess. Intimidate him.
Yeah. Of the enemies, who's all still standing? Is it just Grinder?
Grinder and Chev. Chev is on the comms. Chev's on the comms trying to get extraction because this is not going according to plan.
The imps are coming.
Yeah.
So... I have two successes. I intimidate Grinder.
Okay. So he pulls his axe out of Vox. Mm-hmm. What do you say to him?
I just put down one of my own. I'll put you down two.
He just kind of holding his axe and he kind of looks at the carnage. Four of the five are broken. There's a hole ripped and all you can see is the Kobolt Krayt and not his ship to pick him up. And he, yeah, so he just kind of drops his axe. And he goes, "I guess I was on the wrong side of this one, wasn't I?"
Yeah.
And then...
just like that race!
Yeah! Chef kind of walks over, and he has his axe as well, but he's not, like... he's not fighting, he's just not attacking either. And the door slides open, and people are screaming, and there's smoke, and Mike comes in, and there's, like... blast and armor and stuff like that, and he comes in and he kind of looks around and the door, you can tell, like, he fragged his teammates.
Way to go, Mike!
Also a bunch of civilians.
Well, it was just that fragged only have such a small radius. Yeah. So the door slides back shut and he kind of races over to you and he picks you up and you guys start, like, hoisting people out. So you got Kreblik on the crane, Anders and Remy are helping people up, Vox is sparking and he's in, like, half power mode. He's pretty much, like, not responsive because he has a giant gash into his giant head. Mm-hmm. So I think, as you guys start extracting, the edges of, Coronet start racing past. As you guys are finishing loading up, transporting people up into your ship, and you hear, like, Imperial sirens sounding deeper in the city, and you know that Imperials are heading your way. And we're gonna call that a session.
Anders, get the mask!
Wait, hey. Can I flip a destiny point real quick? So when I jumped off the train, I recorded it, so I can send it to Kevin later.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's our session for this week. We will see you again next week. Hope you had an amazing time, and we'll see you then.
See, it was only a hookup, but Mike cares about me.
We need some vacation time.
We've known each other for what? How long now?
A week.